Well, Rob, how did it feel to put the pen to the paper this morning?
It's good. I mean, I've always made it clear that I want to be a Rough Rider as long as I possibly can, and just to put a full season behind my belt, I'm looking forward to next year. Obviously, you can't top a Grey Cup season, but I feel like individually I can continue to improve now that I know that I can stay healthy for a full season, and I'm already looking forward to it.
Let's go back to that post-game celebration. What went through your mind when you lifted the cup over your head?
It was awesome. I was happy for every single guy in the locker room, specifically guys like Durant and other guys that have been around through the tougher times when we've been so close and haven't been able to close the deal. So just to finally get it done here at home, it was, it was an amazing experience.
And did that solidify your want to stay back here?
For sure. I mean, now I'm thinking about how badly I want to experience the feeling again. You know, had we lost, I still would have been on a quest to make sure I got a cup in a Rider uniform. So there's always going to be pressure, but we've got one behind us. Now we can start working towards trying to build up the same type of championship team.
Does that ever come up in your negotiations, the protected list on the Ottawa
draft? I'm not going to poke BT too much about it. I mean, he's got a lot to handle, but I'm looking forward to December 16th and having a clear picture of where everyone stands. But it's not really something I can focus on. And for me to get in a new Rider contract, we'll see what happens in a couple weeks. But as far as I'm concerned, I'm going to be wearing green.
Is that tough for players? I mean, it's we always have question marks in the offseason because of free agency, but this just adds a whole new dilemma that you have to face.
Yeah, I think it is. It's different, but the good part about it is it's happening so quickly. At least we'll get it out of the way in December. I mean, a lot of the time there's not a ton of clarity as far as where you're going to be playing, before April anyway. So you're under contract, but it's the type of league where, that's just a piece of paper and a lot can change on any given day. So, we'll get it out of the way in the next couple of weeks, and then everyone can move forward.
Darren was talking a lot after, at least on Garbage Bag Day, about locking up the nucleus of this team. That was his first, what he wanted to see. We're starting to see that now. Are you going to start egging him to sign on the paper too?
I love playing with Durant. He's, in my opinion, the best quarterback in the league, no doubt about it. And I wouldn't have wanted to play here without a guy like him. So I'm hoping that he stays in green as well.
I think just going forward, I mean, it shows the commitment on the club's behalf towards me. And obviously one that I'm very, very appreciative of. I'm glad that they had enough faith to offer me and extend me, and I'm more than happy to accept and continue to play here. There's no other place I want to play, so I mean to get locked up and know that I'm going to be here for the next little while. It's exciting, and it just gives peace of mind as we move forward.
Based on the timing, it doesn't seem like it was much of a difficult negotiation.
No, I mean it. I think management knows that I'm not looking to go anywhere else. So I mean it's. It's pretty easy, I think, when it comes down to doing a deal with the management that's in place here. Got a good relationship with Brendon, and that obviously helps out a lot.
At least three of you were locked up until the end of 2015, I guess. What could this line be capable of with that kind of continuity?
Tough to say. I mean, if everybody can stay healthy and continue to grow as players and as a unit, then I think, we got a pile of potential. But there's nothing saying that there's going to be a guarantee just because guys were successful one year that it's going to carry over unless you bring the same work ethic and the same attitude. So I think if we can keep the core guys and we can, keep building on what we did last year, then, definitely the future's bright.
Well, how nervous is everybody right now with this expansion draft? Because it makes things so much difficult other than just free agency.
I think there's a little bit of nervousness there just with the unknown part of what's going to go on. But I think there's so much adversity and so many situations that come up through the course of the year. This just happens to be another one. But I don't think guys will let it affect them too much. And it's still professional football, so guys are going to want to be the best professional football players you can be. So I don't think too many guys are really worrying about it. I mean, it's unfortunate that somebody's going to have to be wearing a different color jersey, but I don't think anybody's losing too much sleep over it.